We are not looking to identify and distribute news. We are not getting into the newspaper business. It is not our job. It is the job of the media and all over Merseyside, and I believe that they do that well. Our first and our only responsibility is to the Wirral residents. Our responsibility is to make sure they are well served and make sure their money is spent in the most efficient, cost-effective way possible. Chair, I believe our proposal is stack up. Doing better with less is becoming a mantra within the entire public sector, thanks to the Conservative government and, as I said earlier, the continued attacks on our budgets and our services. It's incredibly difficult to achieve, and it requires radical and innovative thinking. It requires people to be bold, and bold enough to make hard choices. In my view, this decision ticks all of those boxes and more. Thank you, Chair, and thank you, Committee.
Thank you, Matthew. I'll wait till you get back to your seat. Thank you. Right, I'm now going to invite observations, comments, or even discussion. Chris, you'd like to start.
Thank you, Chairman. It's been an interesting 3 hours.
Yes, it has.
And illuminating in many ways. Well, during that time, of course, you may have seen me scribbling quite a lot. And I have put together a motion overview in the form of time, just to put that on record. We do have anything.
Well, that comes as some surprise.
Really, I'm surprised, Chairman. Anyway, Chairman, we've listened to the whole debate, we've heard from a lot of people, we haven't had all the information we wanted because some of it was restricted. We accept that. But we've heard from the council's head of law. You said this is a risk. This is, his words, a significant departure from the code. So it's risky. We've heard from Mr. Westbrook from News Press, who's told us it's risky. We've heard from Kevin McCallum, who said it's risky. We can't have any more people covering the back saying, hey, you know, the cabinet members who said our decision is lawful. Well, having listened to it, it's lawfully risky, Mr. Chairman. It really is lawfully risky. And we can't just put, you know, £1,278 on a horse, call it what you like, a newspaper, a news sheet, a council talk, whatever you want to call it. We can't put £1,278 on a horse, put it through people's letterboxes, and find the Secretary of State saying, hey guys, we're saving them in Georgia. It stops, we hit the cost, we fight it, no doubt this council will fight it. It's got, you know, it seems to want to spend this money where the people want it spent, it seems to want to spend it on what it wants to spend it on. We then care tremendous cost. Will lose the battle. It is no clearer than that. So I think what we're saying, Chairman, is why take a risk? We don't take a risk into this. As Tom said, we go to planning and we hear all the time, that's not sustainable. If you look away without an appeal, you'll have to approve it because it's not sustainable. Well, Chairman, this is not sustainable. You might launch it, you might deliver it, but you'll be challenged. There's no two ways about that. If you're not challenged by the Secretary of State, I'm absolutely certain use capital charging. I'm absolutely certain the Trinity Miller might challenge it. They might come together as a media group and pool their resources to challenge this council. But this council will be challenged. Of that, I'm absolutely certain. So, Chairman, I don't think we should be taking that risk, but I'll let others speak now. Thank you.
Was there a resolution in there somewhere, Chris?
I've got a resolution to move. Do you want me to move it now, Chairman?
Dave has just indicated he'd like to say something. Answer you.
Thank you, Chair. It was a very informative debate. And the outcome and the three main points that stuck in my mind are, the Cabinet Member said it was a lawful decision, but it was only two of the three objectives that were ticked off in the first box. And obviously there was consent by the Head of Law to go out and ask for further information and clarification of that. But the point, they come back and argue case that it possibly is. The main reason behind the whole object of this particular development is to reach those people who are hard to contact. Now, I want to clarify the point that I made earlier. I think Councillor Abbey took umbrage in the way that across. This whole process is to contact those people who are hard to reach, as mentioned in the report, in selected areas of the area. If this is a pamphlet, leaflet, whatever you want to call it, goes through their letterbox, along with a lot of other stuff from wherever you like, it will just go straight into. We can't guarantee that it will be read. We can't guarantee that people will actually take notes. We can't guarantee that this will actually reach the point where it's needed. I think the money would be far better spent on an outreach workers going into those particular areas, explaining what is available.
Overall, I think this publication is a testament to the ongoing agenda of engagement with local residents that this council has taken. If a business receives feedback from its customers that it's not actively engaging with its customers, it will do all it could to improve that service. This is about engaging residents, not just in wealthy areas, but in socially deprived and economically deprived areas too. I think overall it's positive.
Yes, of course you can.
I'm interested to hear what Councillor Stapleton has just said about all the other public bodies have been consulted and they think it's a good idea that tomorrow, like unless I'm going to the Fire and Rescue Authority, I'm going to ask that question to our Scrutiny Committee because clearly the members of the Fire Authority haven't stopped that. So that's a bit of a, you know, a wild statement, Jean.
Well,
back it up with the
Jean, Jean.
I will clarify that. The Health Authority and the Police think it's a good idea.
Thank you for that clarification, Jean. Right, can we move to the resolution now? Phil?
Chair, I think my resolution is this. Yeah, you need to hear the...
Okay. Chris?
No, thank you, Chair. To make committee aware, we're not saying dealing with the community centre that says to you, but just being a little bit more careful with the council taxpayer's money. So this committee refers the decision back to cabinet. This committee asked cabinet to write to the PCLG seeking their view on proposals for keeping residents informed as per the cabinet report presented on the 27th of June. Two, committee notes and welcomes the offer by NewsQuest to work with the council to fill the perceived gap in the solution and ask that this takes place with them and with other news providers in the media's effect. And three, this committee notes that should this publication go ahead, that the government may well serve an injunction on will and is keen to avoid any unnecessary protracted and expensive legal costs to the council taxpayers at all and wishes to safeguard Borough's independent and vibrant local feedback.
And Lesley Rennie's second to that. Those in favour? Those in favour? Those against? Thank you to the members of the public. St. Jane, home to everybody.